What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I am very much aware that it has been 2 to 3 weeks since I posted a video, which I'm really sad about, so I'm really excited for today's little vlog that I'm gonna be doing. My boyfriend actually ended up coming in town and was here longer than expected, which I'm happy about, but since him and I do not see each other all that much, especially like with everything going on, I didn't want to like film and have the camera in his face, and he's not a big fan of being on camera anyway, so that is why I didn't have anything filmed and posted for you guys. But I just got an Amazon package and I'm really excited about. Let me grab a knife and I'm gonna show you guys. Crazy story. I shouldn't do that with a knife in my hand. I went on a bike ride with my dad yesterday, and I have not ridden a bike in like years, literally years. I'm actually really impressed that I still know how. But my dad and stepmom ended up getting these really cool bikes, and my dad and I went on a ride yesterday, and I'm expecting this to be like just like this enjoyable like breezy little ride. Boy, was I wrong. It was like so intense. My body is so sore, but not only that, the seat is so uncomfortable. I don't even know how to explain it. It's just so uncomfortable. And even while I was riding, like after 3 minutes of riding, I was like, I am sore from sitting on this bike. So he and I ended up going 5 miles on our bikes, and I woke up this morning and I felt like I had literally fallen on my tailbone. Like, I'm so sore. And I also noticed a few days ago that I got this bug bite. So, you know, I gave it a few days and it didn't heal. And it actually, I'll show you. It got very red and swollen. Don't know if you can tell. Yeah, I actually had cellulitis in my arm. So I had to get a shot in my butt cheek just now. And I was like, literally the day my butt is already like so sore. Sorry, that sounds so inappropriate, but literally like the day that I'm already feeling it from the day before, from that bike ride, I have to get a shot in my butt. And I was like, honestly, that's just my luck. But anyways, it's fine. Everything's gonna be okay, hopefully, I think. But let me show you guys what I just got in from Amazon. I've been literally like ordering so much off Amazon lately. It's probably not a good idea to be spending the amount of money I'm spending, but we're just gonna go with it. So if you guys do not follow Kaylee Varney or subscribe to her channel, she's super cute and has like the best videos ever, but she posted on her Instagram these really cute mugs that she had gotten off Amazon, and this was a little while ago, and I had saved them for later on my Amazon account because I still live at home, so for me to like have my own what's it called, my own Tupperware is a little bit excessive with the amount that we already have. But you know what, I saw them and I was like, these are just really cute, and I went ahead and ordered them. So I know that like everybody has these mugs, but I don't really care. They're cute, I like them. So it is the brand called Brew to a Tea. Also the packaging's pretty fun, Brew to a Tea. And I'm gonna show you what they look like. So let's hope they're not broken. I feel like sometimes ordering glassware on Amazon, or just like at all ordering it from anywhere, is dangerous. Ah, they're not. Oh my God. So if I could get them open. Oh, I thought I just broke it. Okay, so cute. So it is it, it's not double lined. It's just, actually, yeah, it is, because on the bottom you can see that there's like, so I think that this mug is, yeah, it's double lined. It's just kind of hard to tell. So if you have like hot tea, hot coffee, whatever, anything hot in here, it's not gonna be hot on the outside. So I'm really excited about that, because the mugs that we have, the ceramic mugs we have, get really, really hot and I just can't hold them. I've actually burnt myself multiple times on them. So I'm hoping that this actually doesn't, like the outside does not get hot, so I don't burn myself. But they come in a set of 4. Let me show you the packaging quick. And they're just the cutest things. But I actually ended up just getting off work and I have my first, my first meeting with my life coach today at 3. So I'm like freaking out about it. I'm so excited. So I don't have like a ton of time to like do a lot of vlogging before that happens. But typically on Fridays I do not work, but today was the last Friday we did work because we were off so long, we just wanted to catch up. So I just got off from work and I really need to shower, and I only have an hour before my call. So I'm gonna do that before my call, and then I can't wait because I am going to let you guys know how it goes afterwards. I know really quickly before, and I honestly, whatever, I'm gonna rant for a second. Really quickly, I just wanna say that, and I've never been, you know, like growing up, I not growing up, but eighth grade and then like into high school, I pretty consistently saw a counselor. And I think that is so important to just make sure that you are mentally healthy. So if you guys are interested in having a counselor, a life coach, anything like that, I will let you guys know how I like our first call. Her and I actually already had a call together. It wasn't like a session. It was just us kind of getting to know one another. She actually lives in California and we're gonna Zoom tonight, or not tonight, but in a few hours. And I'm gonna let you guys know how it goes because it is through like this certain group. So if you guys are interested, that I can leave like their information below so you can get connected with them. But I'm just really looking forward to it because honestly, it's been long overdue that I haven't seen a counselor or had a life coach or just somebody in my life that can counsel me. So I'm really excited to have that first meeting tonight. I hope it goes well. I'm not really nervous about it. I'm more like excited about it just because, and I think everybody should be excited about mental health and being vulnerable and opening up and just like being transparent about like what's going on internally, because if you keep that stuff in, trust me, you are going to regret it. Like, it might not bother you now, but I think the longer you push things away and like keep things into yourself and like aren't vulnerable with people and honest about, you know, what's going on internally, it just like starts to eat away at you. And the longer you wait, it just gets so much worse. So if you guys are interested in seeing a counselor and like just don't know where to go, I can always leave the information down below of who I meet. You know, just like I said, it is totally normal to talk to a counselor, a therapist, have a life coach. It's very, very normal. And if somebody is like putting you down because of that, or if somebody is like, oh my gosh, you shouldn't see a counselor, those are usually the people that need them the most. So, and I don't even mean that in a rude way, but it just is important to have somebody to talk to. And it doesn't even have to be a counselor, like just somebody that you can look up to and actually value their opinion and outlook on life and advice. So there's my little spiel. I'm gonna end it on that. You guys, I just got off the Zoom call with my life coach and I am just feeling very happy right now. It's only been, so her and I talked, like I said, you know, whenever we kind of introduced ourselves and finding out if this program would be good for me. But this was like our first real like little like learning the curriculum that they go by. Sorry, I'm like realizing now that I filmed that I'm not great at explaining things, which is kind of a problem. But it just went so well, and everything that she read to me, you know, based on like the curriculum and how we're gonna go about things, just made a lot of sense. And I'm just really excited to be able to grow through this. I actually did mention to her, like, and I don't know if other people feel this way, but I'm going to be vocal about it, because say you do feel this way, I want you to know that you're not alone and other people feel the same kind of emotions, because we're all human. I think that sometimes I can become a little overwhelmed, not in the sense where I'm like freaking out over it, but like internally like overwhelmed, if that makes sense. Whenever I am thinking about growing in a certain area or becoming this vision of myself that I really want to be, if that makes sense. So, you know, her and I are sitting here talking about like things that need to be tackled in order to get to this place. And it's like, you feel like everything in between where you are and where you want to be is so much that it's like, sometimes in my mind, I'm like, it's so much and just overwhelming me that like, why not just stay where you are? Because that's comfortable. And honestly, that could go for any other area of your life. You know, like staying where you are is comfortable and doesn't take any effort and it doesn't require any different behavior. But you're not gonna grow that way. You're always gonna have the same issues. You're gonna be in the same place. And so I told her, I was like, I think that sometimes I do feel a little overwhelmed whenever I, you know, have to see like what steps do need to be taken in order to like be this whole person and, you know, have this like healthy mindset. And at the same time though, I am like so excited because like I said before, I think that mental health is very important and actually to me is like a very, very cool thing to talk about. So if you guys wanna talk about mental health and stuff like that, I will link my Instagram again here and you guys can DM me and we can bond over it. And I'm not even saying I have good mental health. I mean, I'm literally sitting here saying like, I need so much help and like so much guidance, but you know, like we can bond over the importance of it and how amazing it is to like really dive deep into your mental health and being vulnerable and being open with people. Like it's just so important and I could get teary-eyed over this. Like it just makes me so happy that I'm finally like taking this seriously, because for a long time I knew, like, I had seen like a counselor before in the past, but I knew I needed to see one again. But it was one of those things where it's like, I don't want to pay for that. And it really does suck that every single thing that is good and beneficial for you in the world is so expensive. Like, eating healthy is expensive, counseling is expensive, working out's expensive, gym memberships are expensive, yet you can buy like a McDonald's Big Mac for a dollar. Like, that's frustrating to me. And then we wonder why the whole world is like crazy and messed up. But I sit here and I spend hundreds of dollars on clothes because I want to look good on the outward and look cute, pretty, whatever, to like the world, yet I don't want to pay X amount to be internally beautiful and happy and like feel good about myself. Once again, I might not even be explaining this super well, but I don't know, like, it makes sense to me. So it's like, okay, I can pay $300, actually more, to have my lips done, but I don't really want to pay $120 to have a session with somebody and really talk and dive deep and get vulnerable and grow. Like, that just started to feel really uncomfortable to me that I was allowing that, because being healthy on the inside and being beautiful on the inside is so much more important and goes so much farther than, you know, being beautiful on the outside. And I think that whenever you are like, you feel stable and not perfect, I'm not saying that we're ever gonna get to this point where we're like perfectly aligned and all that, but whenever you have like a healthy relationship with yourself and love yourself, genuinely love yourself and unconditionally love yourself, then, where am I going with this? Sometimes I like totally lose my train of thought. But whenever you're actually happy with yourself, it like shines through, and like, you're just so beautiful on the outside because you're like so happy and healthy and just a really good version of yourself, the best version of yourself, actually. So I already like really, really recommend this group that I'm going through. I can link it down below. It's called Pivot, and you have an initial call with the coach that you are given, and they kind of explain, like, they get to know you a little bit. It's not like a super long call, but they let you know if it's a good course for you or not. And I am so excited. It's usually, she said, it's like a 3 to 6 month time frame of the curriculum, and you do have homework, which I'm like not even mad about, because I'm very into things that I'm passionate about, and mental health is definitely something I'm passionate about. And I want to dive deeper into why I think the way I think and why I'm insecure about the things I'm insecure about and all of those things. So sorry, I'm gonna cut it short here. It wasn't short, I'm gonna cut it off here. But like I said, if you guys wanna message me and talk about mental health or talk about like stuff that we're going through and feelings and emotions, I am always available for that. I'm so down to talk about that. I think it's like really good to talk about things like that. Then message me on Instagram, or if you have my phone number, text me. I love you guys a lot, and your mental health means so much to me, and it should mean so much to you as well. Don't ever forget that, and don't let anybody tell you different. Okay? Okay, so I just got back from dinner with my family, and my friend is actually coming over now. We're going to have a sleepover, and then I'm having lunch with another friend tomorrow at noon. So I think that this is gonna turn into a little bit more of a weekend vlog, since not a lot of action happened today since I started so late in the day. But I'm gonna keep it like pretty, well, I'm gonna try to keep it pretty minimal and short. But not sure if Shanice and I are going to vlog tonight. Possibly, we might, and that will be fun. But if we don't, I wanna go ahead and say goodbye, and I will see you guys in the morning. I will say really quickly that I had a lot of fun. Oh my God, my camera's not tonight. I had a lot of fun talking about mental health. My camera's gonna die. Love you.
Got a screenshot.
Good morning.
You can see yourself.
I know. Good morning. It's now Saturday morning, and Shanice and I are gonna make banana pancakes.
Banana pancakes.
I've never made banana pancakes. Have you?
No.
But
I have them.
It's only three ingredients, so I think we can handle it. Also, I made my tea, which I already showed you guys yesterday. The ginger tea. It's so good. So let's talk about the ingredients we're using. So
eggs.
Since we don't have. Oh, we need eggs. And we have farm fresh eggs because we're babysitting chickens, so we have like fresh eggs. It's like next level. So Okay, wait. So you have to have self-rising flour, but I don't have that. So we're gonna make our own by adding normal flour, baking powder, and salt, correct?
Yes.
Cool. Now what?
Eggs. We need to mash the bananas.
So how many eggs do we need?
I don't know, probably like three.
So you just need self-rising flour, eggs, and bananas, and that's all, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Easy enough. Bananas. Whisking it. Oh my god. Yes. A little John Mayer action. Okay.
So we're gonna go ahead and get all those ingredients ready and then come back and show you guys.
Ah, two bananas.
Two eggs. Two farm fresh eggs left.
Farm fresh eggs.
Look at these.
Eggs.
Look at these. One of the chickens lays brown and one of them lays white. Isn't that cool? You're so sweet. Okay.
I wish my skin was this
color. I wish my skin looked like that. And that color.
Well, this color, yeah.
So you said two bananas, two eggs, and...
And then a third cup of self-rising flour, but since we're making it ourselves, it might be different.
Okay. So let's get after it.
Get after it.
Well, can't you see that it's just raining? There ain't no need to go outside. But baby, you hardly even notice when I try to show you. Song is meant to keep you.
You guys, so actually a funny story. Like I said, Azadra's in town last weekend and for a little while. And this is like full transparency. I know this sounds gross, but for some reason, I only brought two pairs of socks. But one of them was long, a long pair of socks, and then the other was a short pair of socks. Obviously, I wore the short pair of socks more often. I don't know why I only brought one pair. I know that's gross, but I only brought one pair. And he made a joke about, and guys, I have plenty of socks. I just like only brought one pair for some reason. I wasn't thinking, I don't know. And he made a joke about getting me socks. So I literally just came home and he ordered me socks. Like he had socks shipped to me. So let's do a little unpacking of these socks. They're the brand Bombas. So they're like, they're not just socks. Like he like balled out for these socks. Okay. Hold on. Let's see which ones he got. I called him and I was like, oh my god, you sent me socks? He was like, I didn't want to smell your stinky feet. And I was like, oh my god. Oh, they're like super nice. Aw, that's really cute. So he wears these like shoes that like he needs socks like this for. Like the ones that like cover your whole foot, but like they don't come up past your ankles, so like you don't want them to show. So they're cushioned no-shows. They're like so soft, wow. And then he got me this 4-pack of, oh wait, I'm confused. They're all cushioned no-shows, but he got me, I thought these were different because these came in a pack and then this is separate. Maybe he wanted me to have 5 pairs for 5 days of the week, I don't know. Well, I think that was really sweet. Also, something I've been so excited about and waiting for. So, something about me is that I absolutely hate jean shorts because they just never fit me well. And I feel like a lot of people can relate. Like, I, let's say my waist is smaller. My waist is definitely smaller than my hips and my, like, butt and thigh area. So, it's really hard for me to find. And honestly, bottoms in general, but especially jean shorts because I don't want my butt hanging out of my shorts. And I also don't want them like fitted to where they're like tight in the legs. I really like a lot of space, but I also need like a longer inseam because I don't want my butt cheeks to literally be hanging out every single step I take. Like my shorts like ride up and it's just so unflattering and extremely uncomfortable. So I ordered a pair from Abercrombie & Fitch because I don't know if you guys have seen, but they have a line called Curve. So I'm really hoping these are as good as the reviews were. There were so many reviews about them, and the color that I actually wanted they did not have in stock. But oh, these look very large. These are them, and I got them in a size 30, and they were $59. They might have been on sale though, because they usually have like pretty good sales on their website like pretty frequently. But they're the high-rise 4-inch short, and I'm gonna try them on really quick, and I'm honestly like nervous because I always get shorts and they just are never what like I expect them to be. They never look as good as I think they're gonna look. They never feel as good as I think they're gonna feel. Like, it's just a whole thing, and I just hate shorts. And every single time summer rolls around, I'm like dreading it because it's like, how am I supposed to go out in this heat and not wear shorts? So it's kind of one of those things that like you can't avoid it. Like, you either just sweat your butt off, or you just whatever, say whatever, and wear shorts that you like don't really love and don't really feel good in because you want to like stay sane and not sweat your butt off. So I'm gonna try these. Oh dang, I took the tag off, I shouldn't have done that. But I'm gonna try these on really quick and let you guys know what I think about them. All right, let's just disregard my room for 2 seconds. The lighting's not great here, and I have this random ring light here, but the shorts are very good. I think I'm just so used to the shorts being shorter that like these being so long is kind of like throwing me off. They're definitely way more flattering. My butt is not gonna hang out at all with this length. This actually wasn't the original color that I wanted. I wanted like a little bit of a darker color, and it had more like distressing over here. They were actually sold out in my size though, so I will get that pair whenever these come back in stock, because I am like really into like the fit and the style. I think it just is gonna take like a little bit of getting used to with like the longer inseam. I don't know. It probably even doesn't even really look that much different to other people, but since it's like on me, I can notice it easily. But they're super comfortable and stretchy, and definitely a flattering length and more modest. So I would definitely recommend them. I will also have those linked down below too. I actually try to link like every single thing I ever wear or talk about, just so you guys know where to find it if you guys are interested. So be sure to check out the link or the box down below for the link for these. All right, guys. Well, I just got done filming my Amazon haul, so I'm gonna quickly edit that so I can get something up, because I just really wanna get a video up. Like, I don't wanna wait till tomorrow for this vlog to be done, so I wanted to film that. Also, I've done like a ton of shopping, so I got a bunch of good stuff from Forever 21 that I might end up doing a haul on throughout this week too. I really wanna show you guys what I got from there, because I feel like it's really good stuff, and like Forever 21 is super affordable, so makes it even better. If you guys are interested in seeing that, then let me know down below, because I really like hauls, but obviously you guys might not love hauls. So I am always open to you guys' recommendations. I'm always open to y'all's recommendations. So if you guys want to see something specific, let me know down below. If you guys want me to talk about something specific, my life, more about me, whatever, let me know down below, because I'm always open to filming stuff that you guys will actually enjoy. Obviously, that is why I am here and why I'm filming. I want my videos to be exciting for somebody else and not just me. So let me know down below. Good morning, you guys. It's now Sunday, and I just made myself some avocado toast, and I just topped it with 2 scrambled eggs, and then I have water here, but I'm about to make myself a cup of coffee quick, and then I'm gonna eat my breakfast and figure out what all I need to get done today to start the week on a good note. All right, breakfast is done, and because it's Sunday and I need to like get my life back on track for the work week, I'm going to do all my laundry today and also wash my sheets and bedding. I like to wash them like once a week or every 2 weeks. I try to at least. So I'm gonna do that today and then probably lay out, because it's so nice outside and I definitely did not take advantage of the beautiful weather yesterday. So I need to be sure to do that today. But also something I'm really trying to be better at is meal prepping for the week, because I eat out like a psycho person, like every single day for lunch, and I spend so much money in doing that and also eat super unhealthy. So I'm going to prep lunches for my work week, which is just Monday through Thursday. I'm not exactly sure what I'm gonna make yet. I'm gonna like probably look on Pinterest for some inspo, but I will show you guys what I end up prepping. So alrighty, you guys, I just got done meal prepping. So I just kept it really simple and made salmon, basmati rice, and then some steamed broccoli.
I only have 4 because I only work Monday through Thursday, so 4 is the perfect amount for me. So yeah, I'm really proud of myself. I'm going on week 2 of meal prepping, so I'm hoping that this is gonna like actually be good, because last week, it wasn't that it wasn't good, it just didn't fill me up that well. I am going to wrap the vlog up here because my weekend is pretty much over. I'm just gonna finish eating dinner with my family and shower and get ready for bed and then get ready for the week. But I just wanna encourage all of you guys to love a little bit more moving forward, just with everything going on. There's really no words to make sense of the situation, and I love each and every one of you, no matter what the color of your skin is, or anything for that matter. But yeah, I just think that the world could use a lot more love and acceptance. So I just want to encourage you and myself to just do that a little bit better moving forward. But I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. I had a lot of fun filming. If you guys are new here, be sure to subscribe if you enjoyed this. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.